What is going on, everyone? My name is Shackbeck, and today we have some new Prime Packs. Yes, these packs are always delivering the goods. They're not as, you know, on time, as consistent as we'd like them to be, but damn, when they come, do they deliver. In these packs, we have a pink diamond Derrick Rose. We're ready to pick him up for the team. Also, may also point out that in the top right, doesn't actually say the alternate account. This is my account. Oh, and I hate spending money on this game, man. It's so bad. I hate it with a burning passion. Let me give you guys a little lesson. A lesson on inflation. Maybe not inflation. I may be completely wrong as to what I'm talking about. There's a good chance I'm wrong. But let me talk to you about currency and how it works in Australia. A normal 450k VC bundle for somewhere in like America would be about $99.95, I think. About $100. But due to the Black Friday sales, they've gone down even more to about $85, if I were to guess. I'm not 100% sure, but it's around that area. Now, let me tell you about beautiful Australia's currency. A 450k VC bundle is $150. And then to Black Friday sales, it goes down to $120. Even on Black Friday, we still have to pay more. God, I love Australia. I love it so much. But anyways, we have these packs to look forward to. Look at this pink diamond Derrick Rose. He's looking beautiful. We have a diamond Kobe Bryant, a diamond Carmelo Anthony, an amethyst Joaquin Noah. We got an amethyst Carlos Boozer and a ruby Evolution BJ Armstrong. Not bad. Obviously, we're looking to try and get these three cards. These ones, I think these three, especially Joaquin Noah and Carlos Boozer, could be some pretty bad players. In my opinion, I don't think they'll be too good. Joaquin would probably be very good defensively, but not offensively. I don't like that. They need to be good offensively. So these three cards is do or die by. Derrick Rose, I know, has 99 speed. I'm just hoping and praying that it all works out and we can pull them. All right, we have to dig deep. We have to dig deep and pray that we manage to pull this card. I have 450,000 VC to do it. Surely there is a chance. I've seen a few other people's pack openings and the odds aren't great. But all I'm gonna say is that I have belief. I have belief in my chest. We're gonna do it. I got this, all right? You can't have success without belief. And so that's what we're gonna have today. Let's just jump right into it. Let's just get straight into this one. 20 Prime Series 1 packs. Oh my goodness, this is extremely risky. Can we not waste our money? That'd be very much appreciated. I'd love a 99. First pack. Ah, oh, beautiful. We're getting it. We're getting a taste as to what it'll be like. This is a great start. This is a beautiful start. All right, come on. An amethyst, look at that. Already pulling an amethyst in the second pack. Not bad. What do I want? I don't even really care. Joaquin Noah or Carlos Boozer. Probably Joaquin just because it's an Evo. And I didn't see a star, so it's probably Carlos Boozer. There he is. Okay, not terrible. Second pack, we've already pulled an amethyst or higher. That's fine, but I mean, it's not what I'm looking for. Can we pull something a bit better? 2K? 2K, don't let me down today. I really don't want... Oh my god! That's the third pack! And we've got a diamond! I pulled in three packs an amethyst and a diamond. That's fucking nuts. What the fuck is this start? This is unreal. Kobe or Carmelo? Probably Carmelo. I kind of want that Carmelo. That's looking like a Knicks. Yes! We got Carmelo Anthony, baby. Let's go! We got a diamond Carmelo already. Dude, this is an unreal start to the fucking pack opening. Three packs in. Nuts. Nuts. This is amazing. Great pack opening already. 450k VC. Much worth it. Mucho worth it. I don't even know if that's the correct way to say it, but oh my goodness. What a start. This is unreal. My goodness. But, as of yesterday, I did a bunch of filming with my, good friend Eddie, and, what we're basically doing, filming a bunch of stuff for my birthday. We also filmed a pack opening. That was so much fun. Eddie opened packs for the first time ever, which was interesting for sure, because I had to teach him, I taught him a little bit of how to play 2K as we get BJ Armstrong, the Evo card. Taught him a little bit of 2K, which was actually quite fun. I hope he enjoyed it, but we ended up making a really funny video, a dope video that I hope you guys will be able to watch very soon. Birthday video, I won't say much about that. All I know is that one will probably come out pretty funny as well. I think it was quite funny, so I don't see why you guys wouldn't enjoy it. This is why I don't open boxes, man. They're so quick to go through. So freaking quick. Coming up to the last three packs of this box already. We had some pretty good luck in the first three packs. Can we get some good luck in the second three? Ooh, there it is. There's an Amethyst. Not bad. Who is this one going to be? Can we get Yoki? No, yes, we can. We've already got the majority of the players we need in this Prime set. And what? We're one box in. Not bad. I'm happy with that. That's pretty good. One more pack. Can we get a pink diamond? That'd be very much appreciated. Nope, just all silvers. I'm not stressed, man. I'm not stressed. That was actually a very, very good first box. A diamond Carmelo. I will take that. I will absolutely take that. I'm kicking myself now that I didn't actually spend a little bit less, because it would have been nice to actually, you know, have some have some money actually saved, because 450 VC I think is a little bit overkill. But we're not stressed. We're not that stressed. We still got plenty of boxes to go. And plenty of opportunities to get the pink diamond as we get another Amethyst. Okay, these packs are not bad. Not bad at all. That is not... That's a Lakers player. Is that LeBron? Or is it... Yes, LeBron! We got LeBron. I don't think I actually have him as a current day card. Not bad. That is absolutely fine. Probably actually better than the Amethyst in the current collect... In the current... Oh, in the Prime's collection. It's probably a lot better, so not terrible there. I can live with that. Oh, 99 speed is really getting me excited. Not in that way. Hey, watch it, watch it, mate. I'm pulling sapphires out my ass though. I don't need that right now. I need some good luck. All right, next one's gonna be a superstition pack. Bang, we got nose. We're already getting emeralds off the rip. That's not good. Anyways, I'm gonna talk a bit of NBA. Keep this ball rolling. I'm actually extremely excited to see how Kemba plays in the next game, because that injury looked extremely serious. The Kemba Walker injury that looked like he was going to have some problems walking in the future. That was a scary, scary moment. But thankfully, just the neck sprain, and doesn't even seem that serious of a neck sprain. He's already back. Thank goodness for that. 12-4 at the moment. Could be a bit better. I think a few games were right on the edge and would have been really nice if we could have just brought them over. Definitely some winnable games. I think that first one against Philadelphia was probably the only loss that we've had that was kind of like convincing, where we go, okay, we were outplayed from the beginning to the end. So hopefully we don't have a repeat of that. Hopefully we can just get a quick dub against whoever we're playing. I can't remember. No, we're playing Brooklyn. That's right. Kyrie isn't there. I remember all the talk about that. Kyrie isn't playing. Oh, man, that is frustrating. 100% very frustrating. We want to see Kyrie Irving, and we want to boo him. For people who aren't really sure why Celtics fans want to boo him, there was a point in time where he addressed an entire crowd that he wanted to re-sign with the Celtics and then went to Brooklyn. So, I mean, if that doesn't tell you enough, then I don't know what does, but all... I know is that we are not happy. We are not happy with Kyrie Irving whatsoever, especially the fact that he isn't going to be playing against us in a comeback is pretty frustrating. I saw an interesting tweet the other day as well about Kyrie Irving and, you know, his role on certain teams. Back when he played for the Cavs a lot of the time, I think by himself, he'd struggle, especially when he was a rookie. But he had the excuse of being a rookie. It was absolutely fine considering he was. The thing that it was trying to point out, though, is every time he's been by himself or played for a team by himself as the main leader, they've struggled. Boston Celtics, in their second season with Kyrie, struggled. But their first season, when Kyrie got injured, made a playoff run and almost made the finals. So that says a lot in itself. And then when he came back, we ended up going like 47-35, something ridiculously low, something that wasn't really expected from that Celtics team. And same happened with the Cavs. Same happened where his first season with the Cavs was quite disappointing, and his first few seasons with the Cavs could have been a lot better. But obviously, yeah, as I said, being a rookie, he gets that excuse. And now with the Nets, they've started off pretty disappointing. you know, not like how people expected the Nets to start off. Man, I hate how fast I rip through these packs. It's so frustrating seeing the number slowly, well, not even slowly now, just quickly go up and go up and go up. I don't like it. I feel my money falling away. It's not great. It's not a good feeling. We're getting sapphires and emeralds out of us at the moment. We can't pull anything above an amethyst right now. That diamond, literally our first three packs was the peak. How is that even possible? I need a Derrick Rose, please. There we are. There's an amethyst, but it's not a pink diamond. I'd like a pink diamond. We get Joakim Noah. She's in terrible. I'm not angry, but at the same time, I don't want any more amethysts. I want a pink diamond, boy. Three more packs left for this box. Hopefully, we can pull something out here, because I do not want to leave this box. Oh, another amethyst. Far out. That's not great. That's another Joakim Noah. Come on, man. I don't want Joakim. I don't want him. I want Derrick Rose. I want your teammate. You are useless. My hope with this game is that we can see just, you know, signs that Kemba isn't too affected by the injury that he sustained. Because I think Kemba, even though it did look very bad, I think he'll be fine. I don't think he'll have a great performance against the Nets, but I do think he'll at least play up to standard. If I were to guess, maybe a 15 to 20 point game, which would be fine for Celtics fans. I think even tonight, Celtics fans just don't want Kemba Walker to play. We want to just make sure that he doesn't get injured, that he stays okay. We don't want any second injuries or anything like that. Just stay healthy, man. Stay healthy. Celtics fans have dealt too long with players getting injured. Gordon Hayward, I need him back as soon as possible. He was playing incredible, and he had his confidence back. No one has really stressed too much about Gordon Hayward's injury, though. Like, legit, I haven't seen anyone stress out. Maybe, like, when the injury happened, people were frustrated and finding out that he actually broke his hand, but ever since then, absolutely everyone's fine, because the confidence with Gordon Hayward is back. We're all confident again, and that's all we wanted. Just that confidence, knowing that he's going to come back and he's going to play up to standard. It's a good feeling, though. It's a very good feeling. Something that was almost lost with Gordon Hayward for a couple seasons, was just the fact that every time he stepped on the court, no one was confident. I don't even think he was confident. Anyways, coming up to the last packs here. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like we'll get to pull that pink diamond Derrick Rose, but we do have a diamond Carmelo Anthony, so I'll be sure to get a gameplay out on him. That'll be extremely fun. I'll be happy to see that one. I literally could have ended the video in the first three packs, and I would have peaked. It would have been enough content, enough excitement for you guys to justify uploading this video. But I kept opening, and it seems that may have been a bad idea, but I'm not stressed. Carmelo Anthony looks like an incredible card. 99 offense, that's awesome. That is so good. 3.93. I just need to make sure he's got that quick draw. He's got a 95 mid-range. He was always very good at that mid-range. I remember that. He got a 92 post-fade. All right, not bad. 85 driving dunk. 91 ball handle. Carmelo Anthony with a 91 ball handle? Really? Okay. I'll take it for sure, but geez, that's very generous. 92 speed, 87 speed with ball. That's good. 82 strength, 90 vertical. I am so used to the Carmelo Anthony of today, who's just not athletic to the point and doesn't have that much ball handle to the point that this card just surprises me looking at it, which is actually crazy to think about. I also want to look at his badges. He's got 6 Hall of Fame badges. That's nice. Hall of Fames are volume shooter, catch and shoot, Tyler scorer, difficult shot, slippery off ball, and dead eye. Hall of Fame dead eye will be good. Gold badges, relentless finisher, post spin technician, drop stepper, ankle breaker, lob city finisher, contact finisher, space creator, stop and go, tight handles, clutch shooter, acrobat, deep fades, quick draw. There it is. Gold quick draw and gold range extender. That's very good. That's very good for this card, as well as gold corner specialist and gold steady shooter. I like that. This card is very good. A 6'8 small forward, Carmelo Anthony. I am happy with my pull. I'm very happy with my pull. I'd be lying if I said I'm disappointed I didn't end up getting that pink diamond D Rose. But I'm not stressed. I'm absolutely fine with it. But other than that, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you did enjoy, please be sure to leave a like. Comment down below any video suggestions, ideas, constructive criticism. Everything is very much appreciated. And subscribe to the channel if you're new. The support has been incredible. The Agent Zero video, the meme that I did, actually ended up going on his story. He ended up finding it. So that was pretty cool. So thank you to everyone who's been commenting on that. Thank, just, you know, finding it funny in general was pretty cool. No hard feelings, Agent Zero. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye.